already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing. Welcome to Power Sewing. I'm Sandra Betzina.
I'm Ron Collins.
Okay, what are we doing today, Ron?
We're going to do machine pad stitching.
All right.
And taping of the row line. And
this, I do that too. I did that on this jacket.
This is wonderful. I think I learned this from you, Sandra,
well,
15 years ago, and I've been doing it ever since.
Well, I'm still doing it, so it must be a pretty good technique.
It must be really good.
Okay.
Now, where's the machine pad stitching done in a garment? It is done on a tailored jacket, men's or women's. And what we have here is the pad stitching is done on the front of the jacket. And taping of the row line is also done on the front of the jacket.
But see, it doesn't show because when it turns out...
Right, you can't see it.
And it's about a quarter of an inch apart, eighth of an inch apart, however much you want to do, because the more you do, the heavier it becomes.
Exactly. And the reason we do this is to give the lapels some shape, mm-hmm. prevent it from stretching out. And taping of the row line, which is done after you do the machine pad stitching, you actually build in some shape into the garment. Okay.
Right.
So right here, you can see we have the machine pad stitching done on one side. We have the row line, and then we have the twill tape.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So that's what we're going to accomplish today. But let's talk about interfacing a little bit here, because the thing is, and I do this with all my tailored jackets, is I fuse the entire front of the jacket with interfacing. And this would be like that arma weft, which is usable. I'm not quite sure, what did you use in your jacket?
I used arma weft too.
You used the arma weft. So you fuse the entire jacket front right into the seam and hem allowances.
And that gives it that nice crispness all the way into the armhole,
yes.
which makes it nice.
And these jackets travel a lot. We don't have a lot of time for pressing in our hotel rooms because we prefer to be out on the town.
That's true.
So another thing, after you fuse the entire front, I do additional layer. I don't know if you do this, but I think I've learned this from you too.
Yeah.
What we're doing is on your tissue pattern piece, you will see the row line marking. We're going to cut additional layer of interfacing from the row line over.
And do you need a press cloth?
We'll use a press cloth. So
okay.
If you can put that right over top of the first layer, which is fused on.
Okay.
Now, when you cut out the second layer of interfacing, make sure that the grain line of the interfacing is running parallel to the row line.
Right.
Okay? And that also prevents your lapels from curling up, because over time, sometimes they decide to get a mind of their own
yes.
and start to do this on you. Okay.
So that means that the lengthwise grain went this way.
That's right. And the first layer went this way.
Yes.
Okay. So once that's done, sometimes I just allow this to cool for a moment or two. And then we're going to go over to the machine and we're going to do machine pad stitching.
Okay.
This is just, it's done with a regular stitch length. And I'm coming a quarter inch over from
the edge,
the second layer cut mm-hmm. edge of the interfacing. So I'm starting at the top. And this stays in a garment. You don't pull this out after a while.
And you just use a regular stitch length.
Just a regular stitch length. And I never do directional sewing, meaning don't always start at the top and work down. Here I've ended at the bottom. I'm going to start at the bottom.
Right. So you just kind of go back and forth. And you really don't have to draw all these lines. You can just ride the presser foot on
right.
the side.
Now, we should have, if we were thinking ahead, Sandra, we could have put on a quarter inch wide foot.
Oh, yeah, we
right.
could have.
We could have. But here we have more like 3/8. But it'll give you an idea what we're doing. And these don't have to be perfectly sewn straight. Now, like I says, never do directional sewing, because with some fabrics, if you get into some like a lightweight crate, if you always start at the top and sew to the bottom, before you know,
it'll distort it. And the same with when I'm quilting in front of something, I go up and back and up and back.
Now, I would like to do this entire lapel, because the thing is, if we don't, then you don't see how we're going to build some shape into this.
Yeah, just lengthen your stitch a little bit. Usually do the regular stitch length.
Regular stitch length. Now, how did you learn this, Sandra?
I learned it from, I've worked with a woman who had worked in a couture house, and she'd made these beautiful jackets. And I learned so many good things from her, and this is what she did.
Yeah. Wonderful.
Did not even, this was years ago.
And how many years?
Probably 30 years ago.
Well, I was very fortunate. About a year and a half ago, I spent 13 days with a tailor back home in Saskatoon, and this kid was amazing. He didn't use patterns. He would measure your body, and he would chalk the pattern on the fabric.
Oh.
And we spent 13 days together. It was like heaven. Because the thing is, you know, us sewing teachers, we enjoy teaching. But I think we enjoy taking classes, too.
Yeah, we enjoy learning.
So this was one thing that he didn't know about. The thing is that they would do hand pad stitching, which you really have to do a lot of to master.
And that takes a lot of the reason for doing that is to give it more shape.
Mm-hmm. And this is exactly what we're doing here. So we're going to continue this. Now, you don't have to do this right to the lapel point.
Yeah, I usually about that time I stop.
About 3/4 of an inch. We're going to do one more row here. And we're going to stop. And let's do some pressing over the hem now.
Okay. And you're probably thinking, why are we pressing on the hem now? Because we don't even have the facing on. But see, this, you want to get more shaping in there. The more shaping you can get in there, the better.
Because you're just working with one layer of fabric.
Let's come up just a little bit.
Okay. Can you get that?
Uh-huh.
Now, if I'm working with a bad boy fabric, sometimes the fabric kind of wants to bounce back on you. So while it's cooling, I take pins.
Yeah, I agree.
And I stick it right into the hem like this. And I allow this to cool.
Right.
And sometimes I even consider, while this is doing, I always consider doing something like this. Okay.
Yeah. And just let it sit there for a while.
And work on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now I want to show you one more thing here regarding the interfacing. Let's take this sample off, Sandra. And now on this jacket front, we fused the entire front and then we fused on the lapel. You see what I did on this jacket front? I cut out about 1/8 inch.
That's what I did on this one.
Doesn't that make a big difference?
This fabric was so thick.
So thick or so heavy. I do this in a wool melting of the heavy fabrics. And what this does is prior to fusing the interfacing on, cut about 1/8 inch out right on the row line. And what this does, it gives you a natural break in the fabric. Mm. And I didn't do it on this jacket because it was a lightweight fabric.
Right. I did on this one. Even a fabric this heavy is not going to give you a really crisp roll, but any of this kind of thing you can do to help it. So that's why I did do it on that.
Looks good.
Okay.
Okay, so let's set this aside. We're done with that. Let's go back to our original front.
Okay.
From there, we're going to tape the roll line. Now, taping the roll line builds in shape. I don't know if you can take a close look at this, but do you see how this, because if I lie it flat, it's sort of cupped a little bit in this area. What I've done here is this entire piece of twill tape is sewn down. I sew the first 1/3. Before I sew the second 1/3, I stretch it a bit,
mm-hmm.
maybe about 1/4 inch shorter.
And that's what pulls it in, this part
and
of the body.
So when you do up your jacket, it cups the body.
It lays.
And it makes it look like you've been working out at the gym.
Right.
Which I don't do. Heaven
you
forbid.
You look like you do.
Oh, heavens no. Okay. So this cups the body. Now, would you do this in the women's jacket?
I do. And
yes.
with a woman that has a large bust, I would start it a little lower and I'd end it a little higher and try to pull in as much as I could.
So you're easing that 1/4 inch right over the fullest part of the bust line.
And with a large bust, I'll probably get a half inch.
A half inch, a little more.
Okay.
Play around with it, but this here's usually the standard. Okay.
Yeah, you'll see how it's done right now.
Okay, so do we have, I have a ruler. Do you have like red chalk or yellow chalk over there, Sandra?
Let's see.
I don't have anything.
Here's a little
chalk
in her. How about that?
Okay, sure. I need some bright to really show up. Okay.
All right, well, how about this one?
The black. Perfect.
Black.
Okay. Now, when you sew your twill tape on, don't start right at the bottom, okay?
Because then that will show when it
turns
out.
Then you'll see it down here below. So I come up minimum 2 inches. Let's go a little bit more. Let's go 2.5,
okay?
Don't sew it right up into the cut edge of the jacket. You see how that, I shouldn't have done this. This is what not to do.
Because you don't want too much stuff going on in that point.
In that lip, seam up in the top. So come down 5/8, okay? So then you're gonna take twill tape.
So see this, so when he sews the point of this, the point will be here and it won't be involved in that.
Now we have twill tape here. I use polyester because I find with cotton, it tends to, sometimes with some cheap cottons, when you press it, it shrinks too much.
Okay.
So I use polyester. And this here is a 1/4 inch wide polyester twill tape.
Okay.
You're gonna take it that length minus 1/4 inch.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll snip that. Okay, 1/4 inch shorter.
And remember, if you're large busted, I would take that minus a half inch and do it a little longer. Okay.
We're gonna take the twill tape, we're gonna divide it into thirds, and I'm just gonna mark that with a pin. Get a couple pins happening here. So there's the first 1/3. And then I'm gonna flip, roll this back. We're gonna get the second 1/3. Okay.
Okay.
There's the second 1/3. So this is where, in the middle 1/3 is where you're going to stretch this.
To stretch it.
Okay, so I'm gonna start right at the bottom. What side do you start sewing on? Do you start sewing on this side of the twill tape or this side? I tend to start sewing on this side, closest to the roll line.
And this is the roll line. So the tape is actually on the jacket part. It's not on the part that flips out.
There shouldn't be any sewing done whatsoever on the roll line. Pad stitching to one side, twill tape to the other.
Because anything like that, it will make it bulky.
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm going to just flip this around. I'm going to go over to the machine. This is done with a regular stitch length. Okay. We're going to start right at the top, like so. And of course, we're using a nice red thread, so it shows up for everybody. And I always stop with your needle down, because remember, once we get into that second 1/3, we're going to be stretching this. So here we go.
For you large busted ones, you start stretching right away.
Okay, so black marker right here.
Okay. Okay.
This is the end of that second 1/3. I'm going to come down 1/4 inch because I'm going to move that pin from there to there.
I want to check your tension. That's gathering up a little
bit. I think so. We got to watch out what we're doing here. Let's just make sure that this is threaded right, because I think we got some problems happening. Anyways, we'll see what happens. So as we sew this, we're going to stretch it.
You're pulling it taut.
Pulling it taut. And then I'm getting to that last. You see how when I come to this last 1/3?
It's 1-to-1.
It's 1-to-1. Okay. So I'll do one side of the twill tape, finish off with a little reverse stitch, and then I'm going to flip the garment around and do the other side. Remember, we're only working with 1/4 inch twill tape here. I wouldn't do any wider than 1/4 inch. Okay, here's that.
You know, if you can't find twill tape in your area or you feel it's too heavy, I'll sometimes use a selvage from a piece of cotton or silk organza. Now, you have to pre-shrink it first, you know. And what you do is you just put it in a basin of water for a few minutes and iron it dry.
Or mist it with the iron and do
okay.
it that way.
Yeah.
So here's that second 1/3.
So you're
I'm
pulling.
I'm gonna pull it again. Here's the last 1/3. I'm not pulling at all.
So this edge of the twill tape is actually butted right on the roll line.
Right. Well, just not over top of it.
Not over top, but butted up to it.
Okay. Now before, we'll need that ham again, Sandra,
okay.
if you want to bring that out. But before we press this, let's take a look of what we've done here. Do you see how this is nice and smooth? And then it starts to get a little wavy. That's what you want.
Okay.
Okay. Let's flip it over to the wrong side. And you see right here, it's getting a little wavy. That's what's going to couple on the bottom.
And you large busted ones that have stretched it the whole way.
Okay. Do
then
you
yours
see,
will look a
you
little
see
bubbly.
How that's cupping the pressing
like
ham?
One?
And Sandra's pressing my fingers here.
Oh, I'm sorry,
so,
I'm sorry.
Geez, that's okay. As my fingernails are falling off from the heat from the iron.
Well, you got to stop wearing those fake nails.
Oh, is that it? I guess they come off with the glue. You know?
So just
see, look at that.
And then I will usually pin this to there, and you probably and do too, and go work on the other side.
Right. Okay. So you can see how this is going to, let's actually put it on Sandra, because, you know, she has more of a bust than me. But you can see how now it looks like she's been hanging out in the gym because everything's so well shaped.
You know, this takes a little more time, but this is what they're not doing in popular ready-to-wear, and this is why we sew, so we can get things that are beautiful like this. So just remember to do it. Now, I always tell people, what is the hurry? You're just going to be sewing something else in a little while anyway, so why not do it right?
I agree.
Thanks for watching Power Sewing. So what do you think?
About what?
Power Sewing.